On this week's Xamarin Show, I have my good friend Christos on, showing me how to use magnets to generate Azure services. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today I have one of my best friends in the entire world, Christos, on. Look at that, he was surprised. Best friend. Christos, on, our product marketing manager for DevTools here at Microsoft. Thanks for coming on, Christos.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so you may be the first product marketing manager we've ever had on. So what do you do, and what does that mean here at Microsoft?
I'm special, right? So the idea is that, you know, when I got the chance to actually do this, everybody were just blown away. And it was a challenge, right? Everybody said, it's not really doable, or I don't think you can pull it off. And then you have a month. Right?
Yeah.
So you actually have to do it in a month.
So you had an idea, basically, to build a mobile app, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what was this idea? What was this crazy pitch that you had from the marketing side of things?
So we started with the magnets, which you have in your hands, right?
Yeah, these magnets.
These amazing magnets that Brady Gaster in our team came up with. And the idea was that we could use a common language to refer to architecture. So when you try to draw something on the board, people try to do a website and it's never consistent. So whatever comes to your mind. So we said, how about if we help people design architecture and solutions using the magnets?
Okay, I've seen this before, like in some different like design for websites or mobile apps, where you go and you sketch something on a board and then you take a photo of it or something and it creates like something, like a prototype, right?
Yeah.
But what you're saying is that you wanted to do that, but for Azure services.
We want to do something more, yeah. So we have the magnets there, and then we put them on the board, and we look at it, and we're like, okay, it looks nice, but it wouldn't be nicer if we could do something with that.
Ah.
And at that point, I say, how about if we deploy that to Azure?
Okay.
What if we could take a picture and take it to Azure?
So take these magnets. So on here, it might be a little bit hard. I don't know if we can zoom in on it. Can we zoom in on it? Is that a thing that can happen? There we go. We can zoom in on it here. And these are all different services sort of in Azure, right? And you have two of them. We have so many services. You have two different sets. Now, so what you're saying is that you can put this on the board and architect it out.
Yep.
And then how would you even go about deploying it?
Well, how about if I show you first?
Okay,
and then we
show
talk
me.
About how we did it.
All right, so what do you need?
We need a whiteboard.
Whiteboard. Okay, let me grab a whiteboard.
Yep.
All right, so I think I have one of these whiteboards over here. All right, look at this muscle, developer muscle. Perfect. How's that? Does that work for you?
Perfect.
Okay.
As long as it's in view.
All
right. What we're going to do is we're going to do a basic website, right? So we're going to start with an app service.
All right. We got an app service. Okay.
Then we have a database or storage, in fact, to put some assets like images and JavaScript files and CSS and what have you. A SQL database for our backend data. And some Azure functions for some serverless log here because everybody loves serverless.
All right. So we're zoomed in now so everyone can kind of see this a little bit better. So I have an app service. App service is like my plan or something?
Your infrastructure and your plan.
Okay.
So this is all architecture, right? There's no code deployed at this point.
Okay.
We're only provisioning the infrastructure that you need to deploy your app.
I have Azure storage. So that's going to be like blob storage.
Yep.
All right, and I have a database because everyone needs a database. I love SQL.
Yep.
And functions. So
and functions. Kind of,
okay. So yeah, now
exactly.
So now what?
So now, you know what? Let's take it one step further. Let's do a key vault as well.
A key vault. What's a key vault?
Key vault is a service we have on Azure that allows you to decouple your secrets and your certificates from your app into key vault. So your app can call into key vault to get the API key or the connection string to the database.
Okay, so my team, we're here, we're saying like, hey, we want to generate this as maybe the architecture for my app, but they're all kind of loose.
Yeah, man, let's do a circle and then everything connects to that.
Okay, so app service is going to use all of these. It's going to use a key vault, a database, functions, and storage.
Yes.
Okay.
And then the next step is I take my app on my phone.
So you built a Xamarin app.
It's a Xamarin app.
Okay.
What else, right?
Of course. So cross-platform Xamarin app.
And right now I'm using the iOS version, but we have an Android version as well.
Okay.
So all good.
So let's get the app up over here. So let's see if we can see that there. So this is the Xamarin app. So what are you going
to
do?
So first thing you need to select the subscription.
Okay.
So we already have an account that is provisioned to speak to a couple of subscriptions. We'll use the image deploy one, which is our test bed for this.
Okay.
So next, I need to take a picture. So
okay.
I'm going to come over here.
So you're going to take a photo of what you just drew
architecturally. So as long as it's nice and not fuzzy, then we can actually pass it in. So
we
can say use photo here. And now what we're doing is we're calling into the Azure Cognitive Services. And straight away, we got all the services back. So we have five services on the board, five services.
So it took a photo and then used what, some crazy machine learning, image recognition.
Yep.
And it also shows the key vault, so also
text recognition.
Text and image recognition together and basically map those services over here.
Which means technically you could take away all the magnets and just write key vault, app service, SQL database, and it will still work in the exact same way.
So someone could do this at home without these fancy magnets.
Exactly.
Okay, cool.
But I'll explain later on what you can do as well. So next, we need to decide where we're going to deploy the resources.
So you're going to actually deploy what you just put via that?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the plan. So we're going to select the region, and we'll go with US East.
Okay.
And yeah, I'm happy with that. And then a resource group. Now you can choose from an existing resource group, which means that we will override your settings and existing resources, or you can create a new one. So let's do Xamarin Show.
And I'm imagining, like, normally what I have to do, by the way, is I have to go into Azure, I have to figure out where all these things are, click 1,000 buttons, wait for it to deploy, et cetera, et cetera.
It's all about enabling people to do things faster.
Cool.
And then all I have to do is just press deploy.
Deploy, I like it.
Boop.
So now it's happening.
It's happening.
It's deploying. But how is it deploying? I don't understand.
So we have the Azure Fluent API. That's the SDK that is available as a net standard library.
Oh, wow.
So we download it. Well, we pulled that as a NuGet dependency in our Xamarin app, and we're running everything from the phone directly.
Oh, cool.
There are different ways to do that. You could have done an API in the backend, but we want everything to be self-contained.
So here I see some things. So why are some things checkmark and some things are, this is like a status update?
This is what's already been deployed, yes.
Whoa, cool. So this is going to then trickle down and deploy all these services.
Exactly.
For real.
For real.
For real.
For real.
Okay, I believe you-ish, because I don't
when,
know
when
if
we
I believe
see it. Right? When we see it.
Yeah. So some of these are obviously taking a little bit longer. I'm noticing here that there's a SQL database. Mm-hmm. I know that takes usually a little bit of time, right? Key Vault was like instant.
Key Vault is the fastest. We were quite surprised. And then to come up with a nice demo or nice flow, we took timings from different services. And we were testing it. So we used App Center as analytics to give us some feedback within the app. So we're testing it within the app, doing multiple cycles to see which service was the best flow, because if you only have 5 minutes on stage, you want it to be quite impactful, right? But when you're doing it for real, when you're actually doing it with your customers or with your team, then it doesn't really matter, right? Because what you want to do is work on the inception, then take a picture, deploy it, and then go and work on the next design just to see what works best.
Got it. So this entire app, right, you said you have an Android version as well.
Yep.
This is all Xamarin Forms, like cross-platform?
Xamarin Forms with .NET standard. And we didn't have the chance to use the Xamarin 4.0, which was just announced, unfortunately, because it was very early days, and we wanted to make sure that what we have works perfectly. But I think one of the plans is to start trying different things as well.
Okay.
Like what I found the other day is that cognitive services can run on a container as well. So you could, or two options. One is run on a container on your own infrastructure, like an AKS cluster, or you can take it on an app service, or you can download and run the model on the phone as well.
Oh, wow, okay. So this is calling out to do the services, which will probably
So right now we're calling out to do the services, but in the future, one of the options is to take the custom vision model, train it, and make it portable. We have a portable option when you train the model, and then download on the phone.
Nice. So it's all done?
All done.
I
mean, we can switch on
Done. So let's hop over to your PC. You can prove it to me.
I can prove
it. While you hop over, I'm going to move this. I'm more developer muscle moving this over. There we go.
Workout day today. Resource groups. And what you'll see here is the Xamarin Show,
right here.
Just deployed.
So it created a brand new resource group. I just want to kind of reiterate what just happened from your mobile device.
Yeah.
Is it create an Azure function, a SQL database, and then I'm also seeing here, what is this? I like to look over your shoulder. So you got app service plan. So it scaffolded all the dependencies for you.
At this point, we're going with quite a few defaults. So when you say, I want to have an app service, we go with a specific tier, we go with a specific deployment model, and same for all the subscriptions. What people could do, or what we could do as the next iteration, would be have a wizard per service that allows you to configure exactly how you want these things to happen.
Gotcha. So kind of like if I'm inside of Visual Studio, it has all the pick a tier, pick a price, pick a whole thing, right?
So imagine as you go before the deployment screen, there will be another screen per service that would say what the settings would be for each service, and that allows you to be a little more refined. What we did over here was making the assumption that as people try to test things out, they can go from the phone onto the Azure subscription as quickly as possible.
Got it.
The nice thing about this one now is I can actually export that ARM template and then configure it as I want to and make it production ready.
Very cool.
Right? So you go from a very early inception stage all the way to a production ready deployment.
Nice. So you have everything scaffolded. Mm-hmm. I'm curious. So this is doing, you said you had a login with your Microsoft account, right? Your Azure account. You got all of your resources that you had, resource groups that you're going to deploy in, or subscriptions, I mean. You took a photo.
Yep.
You then did not only image recognition, but also text recognition. And then you deployed, said, hey, based off of this, deploy these to Azure, got the status back. So one, it also looks very good too. How long does this take to build?
So before I pitched the idea, I wanted to make sure that this thing is doable, right?
Yeah.
So it took me about 2 days to do the proof of concept, which was testing the Fluent API to make sure that I can deploy from the phone.
Oh, sure.
Testing the cognitive service to make sure that we can recognize the logos or the service logos on the magnets. And then trying to put these things together, like do the text recognition as well.
Yeah.
So I had these pieces disconnected in 2 days, which shows that, you know, with very little effort, you can put a lot of work in place. And then what we did is we actually came up with a proper project where we said, you know, we need to have a nice visual front end to wrap all these things. But we spent more time actually tweaking the business logic. Like what happens if people try to deploy to an existing resource group?
Oh, sure.
What happens if you provide their own resource group name with their own characters and it blows up? You want it to happen on the phone before you try to deploy things.
Got it.
So it was these small things that took a little bit more time. But we were functionally complete and ready to QA in about 3 weeks.
Oh, wow. 3 weeks.
Yes.
So one sprint basically done.
It was small
sprints.
Three small sprints. Yeah. And we were done in 3 weeks. And then we had enough time to test it and maybe tweak a little bit of the visuals and the last bit where we do the checkboxes.
Oh, nice.
I was like, hey, let's do some animation there, which was like the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Not needed, but making it nice and appealing.
I always say you can spend like a bunch of time on the 90%, but you spend almost more time on the 10% because you can always be a perfectionist. I want this and this little animation, this little thing.
Yes.
Can we take a look at the code real quick and what it looks like? Because one, it's also open source.
Yes.
Nice.
If we jump onto GitHub, it's under AI Visual Provision, Microsoft AI Visual Provision.
Cool.
And what we also did is, apart from giving you the source code, we also gave you the images to train your model.
Oh, cool. So you could actually probably take these images and then print them off, too.
Yep.
They don't have to necessarily be magnets, although they're pretty cool that they're magnets.
They are. I mean, that's amazing. You can put them on your fridge. You can put them on a whiteboard. But as you can see here, we have the training data set where we have hundreds of images there for people to go and train the model themselves if they want to.
Oh, I see, because you're using a custom vision model, and these are the images that were there. Can we take a look at the custom vision?
Absolutely, yep.
Okay.
So the custom vision, let me just go back into the
training images. So you took all those images, uploaded them here.
Yeah, you can see. Well, we did lots of tests. Let me hide that.
Some with some heads in them, too.
I was doing it for the Connect demo, because we needed to be in the right environment. Now, it's very important. When we started this, I wasn't really a custom vision guru or whatever, so I reached out to the team and said, how do we do to make it the best? And they said, the ideal scenario is to take the images in an environment that you're going to be working regularly, right? So when we went to Connect, I had to take more pictures because the lighting was very different to what we did at the office. But you tag everything on the side. You'll see we have all the services that we took. You need about 50 pictures to get good prediction results. That's important. Anything below 50, it will struggle with the accuracy, especially if you're funny angles or stuff like that.
Makes sense.
And then once you train the model, you can see here, once you upload new images, you need to train again. You can actually test from the site here. So you can take a picture and upload it here and see how far down the line you are.
You don't even have to put it into your mobile app. You can just take a bunch of photos and a bunch of different environments and see.
Exactly.
You could have actually on stage the night before actually said, like, oh, is it actually going to give me the real results?
That's what we did.
That's what you did.
That's what we did. I spent most of my Sunday taking pictures because we wanted to be perfect.
Nice.
And then once you're ready, you press on the get started, and then on the prediction API, it gives you the prediction URL here.
So this is what you're calling from the back end.
Hide the keys.
Yeah.
But the idea is that you can take these URLs and these keys, which I'm going to delete later on, to start playing with the model. And Perfect. Then that's what you need in your app. So if I switch into the code, we have the we have an app settings down here. This is where we put all the client ID, the tenant ID for the Azure Fluent API, and our endpoints. So you can see here two endpoints. One is for the custom vision, which is for the images, and one is for the computer vision, which does the character recognition, the OCR stuff.
Perfect, perfect.
And the implementation was not too hard, to be honest. It's a few lines of code. So when it comes to predicting the image content, as you can see nicely named here, what we do is we take the image which we already took using Xamarin Essentials. We use that library to remove all the iOS or Android specific APIs. So we have an abstraction on top of that. So we take the image, we get the binary data, and we pass it straight into the HTTP request. And then as a result, we get the prediction result, which should contain the tags that we expect in the image.
Got it. Makes
sense. That's the first bit. And then we do the computer vision as well, which is the text recognition. Again, we upload the exact same image, and then it does the analysis on the text.
Very little code here to actually do that.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, all the heavy lifting is done by custom vision. All we had to do was wrap the JSON into an object that we understand in code. And it's all written in net standard. So technically, you can take this exact same library, put it on a web app or put it on a desktop app.
Yeah, and just works.
And just works.
Beautiful. Yeah.
And one other thing I wanted to show was the camera service, which again is the code that we use to take the image and pass it on.
So yeah, so you're using a combination here of some plugins from Xamarin that are open source, Xamarin Essentials to do a bunch of heavy lifting, kind of the platform code, checking connectivity, checking to get a camera, take a photo. Then you're leveraging a bunch of other .NET standard cross-platform libraries to do all of the image recognition. And then all of this code is shareable across any platform, right?
Exactly.
Very beautiful.
That's the beauty of it. And finally, because some people ask, like, how do you do the deployment? You may have noticed that we kicked off multiple tasks concurrently. When we press deploy, everything started running at the same time. So we actually spin up multiple tasks, and we invoke these tasks based on the services we identified. And then every iteration goes, you know what, for as many resources we identified, just go and start a task for me. So one sample task is the SQL deployment. As you can see here, we just use the Fluent API and say, with whatever login, oh my God, look at that.
Password.
Very, very strong password. And this is where you could use Key Vault, for example, to abstract that from what you do. But the idea is that, again, very little code to deploy resources. It's all managed for you. You don't have to go and do the guessing game. That's it.
Boom. Very awesome.
Yeah.
I love it because it's not only just a beautiful looking Xamarin application that you built in less than a month. You got to demo it on stage at Connect. I'm sure that was awesome.
That was amazing.
Yeah. I'll put a link to that in the show notes as well for the entire Connect demo with Hanselman.
Yes.
Which is really awesome. It was the first time I saw him. I'm like, I need you to go in more detail, right?
Yeah.
I need to see this in person. But you can grab the source code, grab everything. Christos, thanks for coming on, showing it off.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, this thing blows my mind. It's so cool. Well, thanks everyone for tuning in. We'll put all the links in the show notes below. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell, do those things on the YouTubes in the Channel 9 so you get the Xamarin Show in your inbox each and every week. So until next time, I'm James. This is the Xamarin Show, and thanks for watching.